পিস টিভি বাংলা, মানবতা সমাধান।
You know, we've heard you so much before, and you know, you've done a very extensive interview with our editor, and so we are familiar with Dr. Zakir Naik. So
I was familiar with the Indian Express, that amongst various places that is there, the one who have not caught me out of context, one of the few places in the Indian Express.
On the one hand, you have these Western so-called liberal opponents of yours, critiques of yours. On the other hand, you know, there are Islamic groups in India itself who have taken offense to some of the things you said. They say you're dividing Muslims, you're not unifying Muslims. They say you're a Zionist promoter. The Deobandis and the Barelvis have their problems. Controversy doesn't seem to avoid you.
As I told you, anyone who's famous, tell me one famous personality in the world who does not have any controversy. One, only one give me. Give me example. Give me one example of a very famous person.
Not a person who got just a prize and finished.
Who has a large following. Who has a large following, who did not have a controversy.
But what still explains your popularity despite all this?
Because the reason is that these people, I know, there is not a single talk of mine which ever divides the Muslims. Now, because the reason, I'll tell you why. I tell all Muslims should come together. And I quote the Quran of Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 103, which says, "Wa tasimu bihablillahi jamia wa la tafraku." Hold to the rope of Allah strongly and be not divided. So I tell all the Muslims, you forget your sects. We should not be divided, but come together on the basis of Quran. Now when I say this, everyone who has the groups, they're endangered. That this man is getting everyone together. I'm not dividing, but they are losing the flock. It is evident. What you have to realize that in never in any of my speeches, never ever will you find in any of my public speeches, ever have I spoken against any sect, even though I disagree with it, because that is my style. But what happens, the followers of these sects, when they see me, they get convinced. That's the reason I call myself a Muslim. I don't belong to any sect, and the Prophet did not belong to any sect.
Outside sects, when it comes to comparative religion, you say you're a student of comparative religion, you're an expert on comparative religion.
Student is a better word. Other people call me an expert. So, I prefer calling myself a student.
Do you believe in the equality of religions, or do you think there is a higher religion and a lower religion?
No. What I believe, Almighty God sent only one religion. Mm-hmm. And sent many messengers. As the messenger preached the religion of truth, and that religion was submitting a will to God. During the passage of time, the message kept on changing. God sent one more messenger, sent one more messenger. And then the final messenger was Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So according to me, God sent only one religion. Therefore, the way when I speak to other religions, I never try and put them down. That is an allegation by others. I believe in the verse of the Quran of Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 64, which says, "Ta'alaw ila kalimatin sawa'in bayna baynakum." Come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term, Allah na'budu illallah, that we worship none but one almighty God. So what I say, that let us agree. Most of my talks are on similarity between Islam and Hinduism, similarity between Islam and Christianity, Islam and Judaism, Islam and other religions. You'll never find any of my talk criticizing. Yes, unless someone, there was a case in America, you should have heard of William Campbell, he wrote a book saying that Quran has got 30 scientific errors. He being a medical doctor, no one could reply for fears. People called me, I went to Chicago, and I replied to all his allegations. At that time, I was forced, because the topic was Quran and Bible in the light of science. That time, besides defending the Quran, I had to take out the scientific errors in the Bible. Otherwise, never ever will you find in any of my speeches, me criticizing any religion. But in a question answer session, when somebody poses a question, I avoid never to criticize, but when I reply, it may sound like. What I believe, there's only one religion, which God has sent. And that is the reason what I tell, I give a solution which is acceptable to everyone. What I tell the human beings, those who believe in God, at least agree that one book 100% is the word of God, which no one will object. The Christian will not object. Yeah, I believe Bible is the word of God. Hindu will say Veda is the word of God. Muslim will say Quran is the word of God. I tell them a simple solution. Let us agree to follow what is common in all these scriptures. What is different, we'll discuss tomorrow. Whether right or wrong. I'm not saying follow or don't follow tomorrow. What is common, at least we have to agree that according to the Bible and the Veda and the Quran, all three scriptures say God is one. Okay, let's follow it. So this statement of mine, but the way I do it, because I'm a man of research, it is so convincing. The people are saying, Hare, you talk now. He's taking a flock. Where's the question of taking a flock? I'm getting you closer to your Veda. And that's the reason I said, if I differ, get a Vedic scholar to me. And we'll have a discussion. I can be wrong. I'm a human being. That is the reason after our talk, we have a longer question and session. It is the way that Sheikh Didat, the person who was inspired, we started. And after that, we took over. After a religious talk, we give more time for a question and answer session than the talk. Because the lecture is a monologue. So we are so open. So what I'm saying, but I convince them that forget about other part of the scripture. At least what is common, let us concentrate. So we can say for sure, this is the word of God according to Christianity, according to Islam, according to Hinduism. What is different? Right or wrong? We'll discuss tomorrow. So you tell me, what is wrong with this? Am I trying to put down a religion? And because I'm a student of comparative religion, I can quote from my memory, and God has given me a good memory. From memory I can quote. Verses, chapters, showing the commonalities. Not that I don't know about the differences. I can give a bigger talk, talking about differences in Islam and Hinduism. I can give a longer talk, differences in Islam and Christianity, but that is not my purpose. My purpose is to get these men together. But, same like as you said, some of the Muslims, because I get all the Muslims together. See, when you have interfaith dialogue, people say, all is right, all religions are the same, Christianity is same, Islam is same, Hinduism is same. So I tell the priest, my dear priest, if everything is same, then you accept Islam. I'll tell the joker Muslim who says all is same, okay, then you become a Hindu. I'll tell the Hindu, I'm saying no, you follow your scripture. But I'm telling you to follow that portion which is common. What is different we can discuss tomorrow. So you tell me, what is wrong in this? Am I dividing the people? You tell me there is no religious channel in the world which is watched by non-followers more than Christians. We have more than 25% viewers which are non-Muslim. 25% out of 100 million is a big number. Most of the other channels are mainly watched by the people. So why? And this the Western world knows, that we are in the media. It is the most popular watched Islamic satellite channel in the world. There are more than 80 channels. Islamic channels in the world, probably more than 60 Arabic, 3 English, 7 Urdu, few Turkish, etc. And they know that our reach is. So why don't they want the message of peace of Islam to be heard? That's my question.
Where does Dr. Zakir Naik go from here? I mean, does this controversy make you stronger, or does it, you know, show you a path which is more full of, you know, such hurdles, and, you know, it makes you difficult to go to certain parts of the world? What do you foresee?
There was a person day for yesterday in the press club.
I was there at the press conference, by the way.
But there was a person who asked me a question, that there was a letter to the editor or some editor's article that came in the Express a few days back.
Editorial.
That, has the UK government given me a megaphone? So what my view is, that they wanted a megaphone to exclude a person who's most popular amongst the Muslims. I feel. They wanted a megaphone. Okay, fine. You know, we have excluded the person who's the most popular. But I feel, inshallah, as I said, that I have more faith in God. Makhroo makhroo wallahu khairul makhreen. Chapter 3, verse 54, which says, they plan and plotted Allah to plan. Allah is the best of planners. It will, inshallah, backfire, God willing. And I don't require a megaphone. They wanted a megaphone.
So are you trying to, if I interpret it simply, you have become a tool for them?
Of course, that's what I said. A tool, but they don't know that, you know, who they're locking horns with. Because I don't care for any of my personal thing, whether it be for my image or whether it be for any seat. I don't have a seat that I have to fight for. I'm doing it 100% only for peace. And if a man who's willing to sacrifice anything for the sake of peace, he does not mind locking horns with anyone in the world who is obstructing the message of peace to be spread.
I just wanted one question to be answered. How did you start reading the Quran? When did you start? When did you begin to memorize it so thoroughly? And when did you begin to speak, and how? And why?
Actually, I was inspired by Sheikh Ahmed Didat when he came first time in Bombay in December 1987. And when I met him, I was inspired. He was called as the Muslim scholar of the Bible and the Quran. And the way he presented his message to the Christians, quoting scripture, he inspired me. And that's how I got inspired and I got involved in the field of spreading the message of peace.
Had you finished studying your medicine then?
While I was in the medical college in the second year in Nair Hospital, I chose to be a doctor because I thought that doctor is the best profession in the world, where it can save human life. And it is a good profession, I'm not against it. But when I found a better profession, that instead of treating a patient who is sick, which is good, treating patients spiritually got me more pleasure. So that's when I changed from a doctor of a body to doctor of a soul. When I found a better profession, doctors are many thousands in the world, which is a good profession, I'm not against it. Don't get me wrong. But when I found a better profession, then I changed from a doctor of a boy to doctor of a soul. And you know that my father is a psychiatrist, he's a doctor, my brother is a doctor. We are a family of doctors, so they're continuing. And I'm a silent partner. I get my bread and butter from there. I'm a silent partner, I'm a partner. But I hardly go there. I've dedicated my life free for the cause of the spread of the message of peace.
আমরা তো সকলেই চাই মহান আল্লাহর প্রেম ও পবিত্র জীবন অর্জন করতে।
আল্লাহু আকবার, আল্লাহু আকবার।
কিভাবে তা সম্ভব? কিভাবে তা সম্ভব?
আউযু বিরাব্বিন নাস।
একমাত্র মুহাম্মদুর রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লামের অনুসরণ এবং অনুকরণের মাধ্যমে আমরা মহান আল্লাহর প্রেম ও পবিত্র জীবন পেতে পারি। জীবনের সকল ক্ষেত্রে রাসূলুল্লাহ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লামের সুন্নতে উদ্ভাসিত পথ ও পদ্ধতি জানতে তাই দেখুন পিস টিভি বাংলার নিয়মিত অনুষ্ঠান দারসুস সুন্নাহ।
সমগ্র জীবনকে সফল ও সুন্দর করার জন্য প্রয়োজন সুন্নাতের বাস্তবায়ন। দেখুন দার্সে সুন্নাহ আজ রাত 8:30 বা পুনঃ সম্প্রচার সকাল 7:00 বাংলাদেশে পিস টিভি বাংলায়। Discussion, debate, rebuttal, conclusion.
Eliminate misconceptions about religion. Get enlightened.
Witness Dr. Zakir Naik in a battle of words. Dekhun, Shommukh Shamore, Prati Riyoshpatibar, Ratnautai, Aapunosh Shamprachar, Shakal Chai Doshtai, Bangladeshe, Peace TV, Banglai.
আমি রসুল্লাহ সাল্লাহু আলহামকে বলতে শুনেছি, তিনি বলেছেন, প্রত্যেক আমল নিয়তের উপর নির্ভরশীল এবং প্রত্যেক মানুষের জন্য তাই রয়েছে যা সে নিয়ত করবে। সহি বুখারী প্রথম খণ্ড ওহির সূচনা অধ্যায় হাদিস সংখ্যা 1।
পরিষ্কার করতে হবে মনের ধূত, তা না হলে চোখ জবান করতে পারে ছোট বড় অনেক ভুল, শরীয়ত বিরোধী বহু কাজ। আমি মোহাম্মদ হাশেম মাদানী। চোখ ও জীবের আপদ থেকে বাঁচতে চান? তাহলে দেখুন চোখ ও জীবের ফল শুধু পিস টিভি বাংলায়।
চোখ ও জীবের কুফল পরবর্তী অনুষ্ঠান পিস টিভি বাংলায়।
But you're supposed to be very well funded. IRF and Peace TV is supposed to be very well funded.
See, what happens that it is not the question of fund, it is a question of truth. Whoever speaks the truth God supports him. So the maximum support that I feel, I don't feel that money is important. And I tell my people, money is important, maybe 10th down the line, in the top 10. Mainly the support of God. So I feel that I sacrificed my profession, which is very lucrative. Not that it was doing well, and now it's doing well. Now so it's doing well. Without me, it's doing well. Yet, I went on voluntary, honorary, without any compensation, yet work for the message of peace. Now when people who realize that this man, he speaks the truth, then many people support him. Supporting means agree with my view. And if you see the voting done on many channels, you find, the voting done on one of the channels. Until day for yesterday, and I spoke to the head of the channel, out of 21,234 votes, he asked me, we did a voting, who is in favor of Zakir Naik, who is in favor of UK government? How many were against you? I thought, fine. I don't know. I thought maybe 50-50. I thought. He told me out of 21,234, only two were against me. And two were in favor of the UK government. 21,232 were in my favor. And if I do a calculation, it is more than 99.99%. And out of that, more than 3,000 were Hindus, he said. Now this is a non-Muslim channel doing a voting. I don't know when I've gone up now. So what I'm trying to tell you that there are many non-Muslims who come. When there were some organizers who did a peaceful protest day for yesterday, there were a few hundred non-Muslims who came. But they supported me because they know that I'm a man of truth. Mahesh Bhatt came. He supported me because he knows that I'm a man of truth and I would not mind locking horns with anyone for the truth.
But you need money to do God's work.
No, I disagree with you. Mm-hmm. Why I disagree with you?
No, but I mean, to have a studio, to have a channel, to travel, to go out and, speak to people. Of course, you need money for that.
I disagree with money is the main thing.
No, but money... You need to be funded.
I disagree with it. Why I disagree with it? Because when we started the organization, it was only one man. Yes, I do agree with you that it does help. Fine. What you have to realize, that's what people think. And I tell everyone, if money was the thing... Do you know my personality that is there? If I do business, the brain that God has given me, and that's what my wife tells me and my family tells me, that if you had done business, then you would have been a billionaire. And I can do that. For me, to earn $1 million a month is very easy. But I'm sacrificing that $1 million for the cause of Allah. And I'd like to give you an analogy. That the second caliph of Islam, Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, he told the companions of the Prophet, and they were sitting in a room, that what would you want this room to be filled up so that you could spread the message of peace and God? So one of the persons said, like you, I would pray to God that this room should be filled with gold so that we could use it to spread the message of peace of God. So the second caliph said, say something better. So next person came and said that I would pray to God, let this room be filled up with jewels and rubies so that I could use it to spread the message of God. The second caliph again said, ask for something better. So they said, Ya Amirul Mu'mineen, O leader of the believers, you tell us what is better. So he said, I would pray to God to let this room filled up with da'is, with du'ats, those who spread the message of peace, the preachers, like Ibn Jabal, Abdurrahman bin Auf, so that I could use them to spread the message of Islam. Now I'm asking you a question. When the Prophet left, what did the Prophet leave behind? Was he very wealthy? No. You are not the poorest man in the world. People told him that you give up the message of one God, we will give you all the wealth in the world. We'll make you the king. He said, even if you put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left, I will not denounce my message. So what we realize, that Prophet did not leave behind wealth. Today, we have the wealth. We have the black gold. Today, the Muslims have the black gold. Compared to the Prophet, we are now millions and billions of times richer. Prophet did not leave behind wealth. The Prophet left behind followers, left behind companions. And these companions spread the message of truth. That does not mean that money is wrong. What Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, that the poor man will enter heaven. Our beloved Prophet said, it is more difficult for a rich man to enter Jannah than a poor man. He didn't say that rich is totally prohibited. But if you're rich, you'll have more questioning. So I disagree with this. What I believe, that God is with me, and the people who want peace to be promoted, they are with me. So I disagree with the statement that money is required. And as a necessity, as not as a luxury.
It's not a must.
No, even it's not a must at all. And the best example is me. I'm not rich. Fine. God has given me good earnings. I'm not saying I'm poor. But I'm not rich to all. It is.
What is rich according to you?
That's very good. What is rich according to me? Is it? But what you're talking about rich is not surely talking about 5,000 or 5 lakh rupees. Surely. What you're talking about is the means. Our resources are so limited. What we see, if wealth was the thing that I'm talking about, I would never lock horns with the UK government. Alone, a single man. It's a single man. If wealth will make me win, it is impossible. I know if I go to the High Court, they'll go to the Supreme Court. I will follow them. They will go to the House of Lords. I will follow them. But in the main court of Almighty God, I know I'm going to win. So my main thing is winning in the court of Almighty God. But even to show to the world that truth will prevail, we are going to fight the case legally. I'm sorry to use the word fight. We are going to challenge them, you know. But people may say, Zakir is fighting, so tomorrow headlines. Zakir is saying he's going to fight UK government. You know, anyone can make a clipping and saying Zakir and I gave an interview to Indian Express saying he's going to fight the UK government. Tomorrow I'll be an associate of Bin Laden. So, you know, we have to be very careful.
They probably think you already are.
Yeah. No, now they've got confirmatory statements, according to them. So what we have to realize is that I am here to spread the message of peace. And I'm not here to support any individual except the Prophet and his companions.
How large is your establishment in terms of people?
We just have to be talking about.
I mean, Peace TV, IRF.
There are many. Peace TV is there, IRF is there. In terms of, I've got school, I've got many organizations, then I'm associated, I'm the chairman, I'm many organizations, all put together would be many. There would be many activity, charity activity.
Ballpark number.
Ballpark. See, we have got medical aid. We give free medical treatment. Mm-hmm. We give free scholarship. So which activity are you talking about?
Overall, I mean, all the activities you head. I mean,
all
you...
the activity is difficult for me to count. So, and I wouldn't like to give a number which would be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But
Hundreds would be correct? Or thousands?
I would say millions.
That's a larger world.
That's what I call. My supporters, they are the biggest thing.
Mm-hmm.
I say more than 100 million.
How large is the IRF?
Fine. You cannot say that Zakir has got 100 million employees.
But just IRF?
Fine. IRF talking about the volunteers? It's yeah. Hundreds of thousands.
Mm-hmm. They're only volunteers? They're not paid employees?
No, of course. It is less than 20.
20?
Less than 20. Paid employees of IRF.
And
specific
Peace,
question.
And Peace TV?
Peace TV is a registered channel
mm-hmm.
in London
mm-hmm.
and in Dubai.
Okay.
People, media comes, you know, it is not appealing for me at all. Fine. You can say I'm the brand ambassador of Peace TV. If you say that, no problem. Like, you know, Shah Rukh Khan, brand ambassador for Tiger. Brand ambassador. So I'm a brand ambassador for Peace TV. If you say that, I've got no problem. I'm an advisor, no problem. But Peace TV, a different entity as compared to IRF Mumbai. Absolutely different entity. There's no link. Fine, I'm common in many places. There's no link at all whatsoever with Peace TV as an entity and Islamic Research Foundation Mumbai as an entity.
To use a very Hindu analogy, you're like Lord Vishnu, you have lots of avatars.
I consider avatar as a thing of messengers.
Mm-hmm.
And we believe God has many messengers, but the messengers have ended. Now it is the Dais. Dais are, as you said, the people who spread the message of peace. Now what you saw day for yesterday was not a call given by us. Wasn't a call given by Islam Research Foundation. It was a call given by more than 40 different Muslim organizations asking for my support. Not IRF. What IRF does, we have seen in the Sumaya grounds on the last day. 300,000 people. Actual number. If you see on the television, it looks like millions. 300,000 people, out of which more than 25% are non-Muslim. What I'm trying to say, I didn't want to give a call. Why should I give a call? It is the other. Now, one Muslim organization goes against me. It comes in the paper. More than 40 are supporting me. It depends upon the media what they want to promote. But I have more faith in God and the truth because I'm not a politician. I don't intend standing for any elections. My thing.
You don't have any political ambitions?
Not at all. Though Islam has rules and regulation for politics, I feel in this age, if I enter politics, I'll have to leave my Islam. You have to leave my Islam.
Mm-hmm.
I feel I may be wrong. Because Islam is so clear-cut. It's calling a spade, irrespective as Allah says in the Quran, Surah Nisa, chapter 4, 135. Stand out for truth, for the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if it be against yourself, against your parents, against your relative, whether rich or poor. So if I do that, today's politics is very dirty.
politics is there in Islam. If you see the way the Prophet, the Sahaba, his companions, the Khulafa Rashidin, upright people not bothered about. Today if I apply that, I will never be able to survive. Even if I come, I'll be thrown out. Because I would not like any corruption. I would not like any bribery. Quran is strict about this, that no bribing. Now, which country in the world that, I don't know of any country in the world where there is no bribing. There may be less or there may be more. Working in such an environment, I feel it will not possible for a person to be 100% Islamic as well as be a politician. Fine, he may compromise. So most of the politicians that I feel, whichever religion they belong to, they may follow the religion as long as it doesn't endanger their
seat. Politics.
Their seat. They will support a religion if they get more vote bank. They may say, okay, now I will support my religion and I may get 5% negative point in my seat, no problem. But where it is too much, then they will forget the religion. That is the reason in my talk on Is Terrorism a Muslim Monopoly, which I gave in Shanmugananda. I said, according to me, the monopoly of terrorism belongs to the politicians. I mean, that's the full answer of giving statistics and everything, which is difficult to give proof in this interview. So that's the reason I feel it. But that doesn't mean that all the politicians 100% are bad. But to be on the truth and yet be a politician, it is very, very difficult.
Thank you so much for your time. It was a very intense and I enjoyed talking to you. I hope you enjoyed talking to us.
It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure.
আল্লাহর ইবাদত করে কোরআন এবং হাদিসের ওপর আমল করে আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন তাদেরকে সফল করে। আমি মতিউর রহমান,
শেখ মতিউর রহমান মাদানী।
কি কি করলে আল্লাহ পাক রাজি হবেন দেখুন ইসলামের স্তম্ভ,
দেখুন ইসলামের খুঁটি সমূহ কাল সন্ধ্যা 5টায় আপন সম্প্রচার রাত 12টায় বাংলাদেশে পিএস টিভি বাংলায়। Marriage or divorce?
What's Islamic ruling?
Nikah.
Love book.
Solution or problem?
Islam to...
Heaven or hell?
There is a misconception.
You choose. Beauty. Wealth. Family status. Virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik. দেখুন অর্ধাঙ্গিনী নাতিত্বাঙ্গিনী প্রতি রবিবার রাত 7:30টায় আপন সম্প্রচার সকাল 9:30টায় বাংলাদেশে পিএস টিভি বাংলায়। কখনো কল্যাণের শিক্ষা নিয়ে
অশান্ত পৃথিবীতে শান্তি সন্ধান চাই,
কখনো মানবতার জন্য বার্তা নিয়ে
শান্তির জন্য সফলতার জন্য আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিন
মামনুন হক
মানবতার উপর ইহসান করলেন, মানব মুক্তির দাতা নবী প্রেরণ করলেন,
প্রয়োজন হলে ইসলাম সর্বদা এগিয়ে এসেছে।
ইসলাম প্রকৃত অর্থে শান্তি কায়েম করার জন্য শান্তির সমাজ গঠনের নির্দেশনা দিয়েছে, নির্দেশনা দিয়েছে।
জানুন শান্তির জন্য ইসলামের অবদান, সমাজে শান্তি প্রতিষ্ঠায় ইসলাম। কাল রাত 8:30টায় আপন সম্প্রচার সকাল 7:00টায় বাংলাদেশে পিএস টিভি।